The right side. That's where they give it.
Big hole.
Oh, Shady McCoy on the loose. He's at the 15. He's running to the corner. He's into the end zone.
Vic tosses it out. And picking it up is McCoy. At the 40. 35-30. 25-20. 15-10-5. Touchdown!
Second down and 10. Hole. Gives it off to McCoy. He's got running room. Steps over a man. McCoy. He is going home.
Toss sweep, left side. Stops in his tracks at the 5, dives forward, heading close to the end zone. He is in.
Number one player in my position, LeSean McCoy. Gotta be Shady, man.
First down.
You can look at him and, you know, try to learn from him, but a lot of his stuff is just being what, you know, God made him to be, making people miss and doing crazy stuff. So definitely he's number one.
I think the signature Shady run from this year is the one in the snow.
McCoy waits patiently, driving up the middle. Shady's gonna score! Touchdown, Buffalo!
No one can find footing. He's the only guy in the stadium that found footing, and he's still out there moving and shaking and juking. I think that's when you really saw his skills come to light.
You can add dominating in snow to the long list of things that LeSean McCoy does that other people simply can't.
He does stuff on that field that I would never even think to even try. Cutting back, disappears on the other side of the field before you know it, making people look silly.
You get Shady McCoy in space, and he can turn the game into a video game.
Holding the ball in one hand, making you think you're going to get it.
He's kind of like a basketball player because he always carrying it in one hand. Some guys tend to get lost looking at the ball and he just like kind of cross you over. So he's kind of like a point guard with the ball in his hand.
McCoy has turned the NFL into his own and one mixtape, crossing defenders up and breaking ankles.
It's hard to touch him, though. You know, it's hard to touch him. He has some of the best juke moves in the game.
The way he cut, though, bro.
Look, that first move he give you, don't honor it. Because if you fall for it, he's going to make you look silly.
The way he cut, I jumped inside, he had jumped outside.
And he's able to, like, cut on a dime, man. I mean, it's, you know what I'm saying? That's why he calls himself cut on a dime. He can really do that.
LeSean McCoy, he a dog, man. You know, very shifty. If you ain't ready, he gonna embarrass you. So you gotta always be on your toes.
You could be right in front of his face. You blink, he's 30 yards down the field.
See that?
Then you look like, oh my God, where did he go? Because he can make anybody look silly.
My goodness, somebody better go pick up some equipment.
Crazy on that one. Hey, you see the moves? You see the moves?
Shady's ability to make people miss has entrenched him in elite company. He became the 30th running back in NFL history to amass 10,000 career rushing yards.
I clearly remember when I met him, everybody was introducing themselves. He said, "Hey coach, they call me Shady." That was the introduction. Never forget it.
It was his first game in 2007. I called him LeSean McCoy.
LeSean McCoy is the tailback, and he gets the call. Cutting it up the middle, has some room.
And I noticed that somebody had left me a message, so I get to a break and I clear the message, and it's for Myron Cope. And he says, "You keep calling him LeSean McCoy, and nobody will know who he is. Call him Shady." And the rest is history. He was just electrifying. You know, when he touched the ball, you knew something good could happen and will happen, and it did.
You know, he could turn the worst play into a highlight.
Just the speed and the natural ability, vision, a generational talent.
Just to watch him for 2 years was a pure delight.
With the 53rd pick, the Philadelphia Eagles have selected LeSean McCoy.
So a running back who played his college ball in Heinz Field is now playing his pro ball in Lincoln Financial.
He went to the perfect offense. He picked up right where he left off in college. I mean, he was a star from day one.
The kid never took a hit, even in the NFL, you know, and that's what separates him from a lot of great running backs.
He's one of the all-time leading rushers in the history of the game. He's on a fast track to Canton. and he deserves every bit of it.
Hello, this is headquarters.
Hey, everyone, have a quarter.